Very pleasant morning to all the students of class plus 2C beta. Today we have been doing this beta rat trap since so long, and now finally with this is the happiest announcement ever that we would be completing this so lengthy chapter by discussing the question answers. Fine. So you would be participating in this. I would be discussing many questions, no doubt, but I want you people to speak also. So whomsoever I would be naming, I have not muted anyone today. Otherwise, I mute you when I'm speaking and teaching the chapter. So I have not muted anyone. If I ask any one of you, I would name any one of you, then you will give me answer. Even if you do not know the answer, you have to just tell that you don't know, so that I can know that you're sitting there or not. You're not switching on your videos on daily basis, I keep on saying. So this is what I can do. Okay, let's not waste time. So we would be starting beta from the beginning. In between the chapter, there were questions based on the pages also. Clear? So we would be starting from page 34. This is page 34 of your book. And kindly keep notes. Value points at least note down. First question is, from where did the peddler get the idea of the world being a rat trap? So how did he get this idea? Few questions I would be discussing, few I would be asking you to speak here, because there are a lot of questions today, a lot of questions. So the peddler had been thinking of his rat traps. As I already told you, he was a peddler, and whenever he would go for daily ploddings, fine, he would just dangle the rat traps around his neck. And once he was just walking, selling his rat traps, and he was struck by this idea. You can say one idea came to his mind, or this idea occurred to him, that the whole world is a big rat trap, and we all people are just like rats, and all the worldly things, all the materialistic things are just like baits to us, B-A-I-T-S. I have already discussed with you in detail what is a bait and how a rat gets attracted to the bait. The moment it touches the bait, it gets shut into that rat trap. Fine. Similarly, we people, when we touch the worldly things, when we are attracted towards the materialistic things, we are caught in this world called rat trap. So rat trap is a metaphor here for the whole world. Clear? So if you get from where did the peddler get the idea? That one day he was plodding here and there, selling his rat traps, and he was struck with this idea that the whole world is a rat trap, and we all people are like rats. And one or the other day, every one of us will be attracted towards those baits or materialistic things, and we would be caught. You would be writing 2-point answers, beta. These are the short questions. You're writing for 2 to 3 marks only. Okay. When it is a long question, then you would be writing 200 to 150 words. So word limit matters the most in plus two class. In board class, you have to stick to the, because you don't have time even to complete the paper. Second question is, why was he amused by this idea? Amused means he was just feeling that he has achieved something. He was so happy about it. Fine. So why he was amused by this idea? Because actually, he was thinking that he has, you know, invented something the way scientists invent. You won't be writing scientist invention. I'm just discussing with you. So what you would be writing in the answer, his own life, you can say peddler's own life was very dull, very boring, very monotonous. Clear? And he walked laboriously from one place to another. When he keeps on plodding, keeps on walking on foot. And the world had never been kind to him. Right? Nobody had treated him in a good way. So during his gloomy ploddings, fine, try to understand the words I'm using. Gloomy is very, very sad and dull. So during those gloomy ploddings, when this idea used to occur into his mind, that would, you know, that had become his favorite pastime now. His favorite hobby, you can say. On everyday basis, he would have this idea. And he was amused how people deliberately are throwing themselves into those rat traps. So by thinking that that there are two kinds of people, one who are already caught in the rat trap and others who are circling around it. Fine. So why he was amused? Because he used to do very gloomy ploddings, and during those sad ploddings, he was struck with this amusing idea, and he used to have a sense of achievement out of it, that yes, he has invented this thought that there are two kinds of people, one who are stuck in the bait, stuck due to the bait, and others are circling around the rat trap. Clear? Now, did the peddler expect the kind of hospitality that he received from the crofter? You know that one day he knocked at the door of the crofter and he just allowed him to enter his, you can say, small house or hut or cottage, I must say. He allowed him to enter into his cottage. And did the peddler expect this hospitality? Just to tell me whether yes or no. Okay, now I have not muted anyone. I would be naming the person and that person would be answering it. Okay, first person is Rana Gurjeet. Everybody will get the turn. Rana Gurjeet, answer kindly. Unmute and speak. Did the
peddler? No, he didn't expect it.
No, he didn't expect. Why? Do you have the explanation?
Because earlier, whenever he visited someone, they treat him badly.
Yes, very good. So Rana has given exactly same answer which I was expecting, because the peddler, firstly, you will answer what is asked in the question. Okay, the peddler did not expect, and always see the form, the tense which is used in the question. So peddler did not expect the kind of hospitality that he received from the crofter, because the world had never been kind to him. Nobody had treated him nicely, fine, or politely. He was not welcomed at any place, being, you can say, a peddler, a wanderer, or a vagabond. Clear? So he never expected, but it was quite shocking for himself also. Now, fourth question is, why was the crofter so talkative and friendly? This question, beta, let me tell you, is quite common. I have seen even in boards, they give this question. Why was the crofter so talkative and friendly with the peddler? So, Sukhmanjot, you can answer for this. Did the why was the crofter so talkative and friendly with the peddler?
Because he was lonely, as he did not have any child or wife. So, he was pleasing his guest. And
so, this question actually carries the theme of this chapter, that is loneliness. One of the themes of this chapter is that loneliness can make, you can say, out of loneliness, there are a lot of traits which we, associate. So when people are lonely, they need a company. They need to talk to others. So what will be the answer? The crofter, was so, you can say, friendly and talkative. The reason was his circumstances were like that only, that he was also looking forward for some company. He was not having any family. Rather than better writing casual language, wife and child, we just say that crofter was living all alone. He did not have any family. Fine, he was living all alone. And out of loneliness, he wanted a company to talk to. He wanted a friend to talk to with whom he could share his secrets, his things. Fine. So that's why he allowed that peddler to enter his cottage. Clear? So that was the reason. He was, and this also shows that crofter was quite generous persona. Generous means kind. So in plus two, you won't be using very casual language. You try to use heavy vocabulary, embellished vocabulary. So now we have question number fifth and sixth. If you can see, I need to highlight. Why did he show the 30 kronors to the peddler? But the spelling of kronor, they themselves have changed. Sometimes they are writing K-R-O-N-E-R. Sometimes they're writing K-R-O-N-O-R. So that is correct. Fine. K-R-O-N-O-R, kronor. So that is the currency over there. Why did the peddler show 30 kronors to the peddler? Suhani. Suhani, you can answer this, beta.
Firstly, the Crofter when he told the peddler that by giving the milk to the cow for the creamery every day, he received all of the 30 kronos. But the stranger or the peddler, he seemed very incredulous. So that's why he went into the through the window, took down a leather pouch, and he showed him the wrinkled 10 krono notes. And that.
Fine, very good. So peddler showed 30 kronos to the peddler because firstly, when Crofter told him that he has a creamery, and he just after milking the cows, he has, you know, collected that much amount. And, you know, peddler was suspicious about it. Peddler just was incredulous about it. He was showing such reaction that he did not believe him, though he did not utter a word. But when peddler showed him, when Crofter showed him 30 kronos, when Crofter told him that he has earned 30 kronos recently out of milking a cow because he's running a creamery, and he did not seem to believe him. So just to make him sure, because he has grown quite friendly with him, he wanted to make him trust him that, yes, I have earned that money. So he just went near the window, he brought that pouch and showed him 10 kronos, 3 notes of 10 kronos each, that is total 30 kronos, okay? Did the peddler respect the confidence reposed in him by the crofter? Let me answer you this question. Now, what is the meaning of this question first? Did the peddler respect the confidence? See, Crofter did not know peddler, but even then he allowed him to enter his cottage that day. And neither only he allowed, he just, you can say, he offered him porridge, cigar, and they just had good conversation. They played majolis, a game of cards also. So if a person has behaved so nicely to you, so it's your duty also to repay accordingly. Did the peddler respect the confidence reposed in him by the crofter? Do you think that peddler respected? Anshulvij, can you answer this, beta? Anshulvij, if you don't know, then you have to speak, beta, that I can't answer. Sorry. I'm just checking whether you are there or not. If you will not respond, you will be marked absent. Keep it in mind. Did the peddler respect the confidence reposed in him by the crofter? Either you can say yes or no. What do you think? Okay, so Anshul is not there. He's there, but he's just for the sake of being there. So I have marked it. Roll number 7, Anshul. Fine. So did the peddler respect the confidence reposed in him by the crofter? No. Exactly no. Fine. So it is clear no. No, the peddler did not respect the confidence reposed in him by the crofter. At the very first opportunity, he just smashed the window pane and, you know, took out that pouch and which was hanging near the window and that leather pouch, and he just took the money and again kept the pouch again at the same place. So then he went away from the way to the forest so that he could not be caught. So it was all planned by him. He did not even think for a while that how nice Crofter had behaved with him. So peddler did not respect the love and confidence reposed in him by the Crofter. Okay. So now we would be moving to next questions. We have questions in between the chapters, so that's why I have to move like this. Yes, now we got this one. Page number 37, it is, beta, of your books. What made the peddler think that he had indeed fallen into a rat trap? What made the peddler think? When did he realize that really he has fallen, he himself has fallen into a rat trap? Peddler realized, you know, that he must not walk on the public highway. When after stealing the amount from Crofter's house, peddler thought that he should not, you know, follow the path of public highway. He could be caught by cops easily. So he just took the way through the forests only so that he could not be caught. And he kept on walking and walking, and he gets so tired, and he was coming at the same place again and again. He was lost somewhere in the forest. And finally, he just fell on the ground. He was dead tired. And then he thought that he himself has touched the bait. And what is the bait here? Those 30 kronos. Fine. And he himself had fallen into a rat trap. He had let himself be fooled by a bait. He touched it and he's caught into it. Clear? So this was the moment when he realized that he himself has fallen into a rat trap. Why did the iron master speak kindly to the peddler and invite him home? So I want Vaibhav to answer this question. Why did the iron master speak kindly to the peddler and invite him home? Vaibhav, if you can hear.
Because he had he took him as his old friend.
Okay, he took him as? Answer is not complete. There are two parts to it. The iron master spoke kindly to the peddler because he mistook him as one of his old acquaintance, means jaan pehchan. So he just spoke very kindly because he thought he is one of the old regimental officer who's known to him. His name is Nil Ulf, and he invited him home because of the Christmas Eve. He and his daughter was going to celebrate. And he thought that his old acquaintance, his friend, is going through some bad days of life. And definitely he should help him in his gloomy days. That's why. Fine. Two reasons I have mentioned. Why did the peddler decline the invitation? Yes. Why did he decline the invitation? Amarpreet, can you answer this? Amarpreet.
Yes, ma'am.
Beta, why did the peddler decline the invitation?
Because the iron master had mistaken him for his old regimental comrades.
Mm-hmm. That was the reason. That is not the reason, Beta. The peddler declined the invitation because he was scared he had stolen 30 kronos from Crofter's house. He was scared of being caught up by the police. He thought soon his identity would be revealed and he would be caught. Fine. So that's why out of fear, he did not accept the invitation of Iron Master. Fine. He himself was scared already. See, this is the way one should participate. That shows that children are sitting and listening to the teacher. And after listening to all the views, we get a final view by the teacher. And that is the best way to, you know, understand the question answers. Let's see on which page we have. Yes, this is page number 41. What made the peddler accept Edla Wilmenson's invitation? Hansika, can you answer this? If yes or no, you can just speak that no, ma'am. I won't be deducting any marks. I'm just checking whether you're listening to the teacher or not. What made Edla peddler accept Edla Wilmenson's invitation? Hansika. So Hansika, I'm just marking absent those who are not speaking. Whether you know the answer or not, you have to tell yes or no. Then Kanubha, this question goes to you. If you do not know, it's okay. Just tell me that, ma'am, I don't know. Kanubha, what made the peddler accept Adla Wilmenson's invitation? Kanubha, are you listening? Okay, fine. I'm just marking Anshul, Kanubha, Hansika, those who are not paying attention. What made the peddler accept Edla Wilmenson's invitation? I told you already, Edla was a young lady with good persuasion power. Fine? Persuade karna, manana kisi ko. Fine? So, Edla, firstly, you know, she was quite kind towards the peddler. Fine? And she just persuaded him in such a nice way that he could not say no to him. Firstly, what happened exactly, I'm telling you, as Adela firstly reached the iron mills, Ramso iron mills, she lifted the hat of the peddler and he jumped up abruptly and seemed to be quite frightened. And then Adela was, you know, having very kind looks, and the way you can say she persuaded him and the way she talked to him in a very generous manner, fine. So that's why she just told her that you can just celebrate Christmas Eve and after that you can leave. So her friendly manner, actually his good persuasion power and his friendly manner, that made the peddler feel confidence in her, and then he decided to go with her, fine. When did the iron master realize his mistake? Fine. Next morning, the stranger was cleaned and well dressed, and the valet had bathed him. Valet is attendant on the house of iron master and Adela. So valet had bathed him, and he cut his hair and he shaved him, and he was led to the dining room for breakfast. And the moment iron master saw him, he, in the broad daylight, it was impossible to mistake him for an old acquaintance. He realized that this is not my old acquaintance. Then iron master realized his mistake and immediately threatened to call the sheriff. Clear? How did the peddler, next question, what did the peddler say in his defense when it was clear that he was not the person iron master had thought he was? So when iron master started accusing him of sneaking into his house, peddler came to his rescue immediately. He banged his fist on the table and said it was not he who has come here. They have brought him here. And then he gave the reference of, again, that philosophical idea of rat trap that he himself has stuck into it. And one day, Iron Master will also go through the same. Fine? On which Iron Master made fun of him also. Clear? Why did Adela still... And, you know, one more point he put forth in the fourth question, he says that no harm had been done by him lately. That if he has entered your house, if he was there, he had not done any harm. Clear? He also said that he would put on his rags and go back again. Clear? In the fourth question I'm talking about. He also suggested he would put on his rags and he would go away. Clear? So in fifth question, why did Adela still entertain the peddler even after she knew the truth about him? Adela did not think it proper on their part to behave like this to a guest. They have invited someone to for the Christmas Eve, and after, you know, giving him meals only, she wanted him to leave that place, because this is a general mannerism, or you can say good nature of Adela only, that she understood the reality of peddler's life also, that how hard a life of a peddler is, how he is not welcomed at any place. At least one day he should enjoy throughout the 365 days out of 364 days. Fine. So why was Adela happy to see the gift left by the peddler? As soon as Adela reached home from the church, she was given a package from the valet. She opened it immediately. The contents were quite visible from the package itself. It was not undone. Package was not wrapped in a nice way. She found a small rat trap, fine. You can say three wrinkled 10 kronor notes and a letter addressed to her. The peddler wanted, you know, to be nice to her in return, and he did not want to be to embarrass her for the Christmas. This thing touched Adela, and that made Adela happy, that at least this man has changed thoroughly just because of her. That's why she was happy. And moreover, she was happy that he has not stolen anything from their place, as father was after her life. Why did the peddler sign himself as, very important question, why did the peddler sign himself as Captain Bondsdale? This question, again, from the board point of view, I'm telling you why, for a long question as well as short question. Clear? So why he signed himself as Captain Bonsdale? The Iron Master has invited the peddler to his house, mistaking him for captain, firstly. Remember, fine. So Iron Master firstly invited the peddler by, you can say, mistaking his identity as Captain Bonsdale, and he was welcomed there as a captain is welcomed. He was treated there as a captain, but even if his reality came out, even then he was treated like a captain by Edla Wilmenson. So peddler got a chance to redeem himself from dishonest ways by acting as an honorable captain. So this actually changed a lot of change brought into his personality. So that's why he signed himself as Captain Bonsdale. Firstly, Edla treated him as a captain. Iron Master brought him by mistaking him as a captain, number one. Then Edla treated him like a captain. Thirdly, he himself has changed and, you know, he adopted nice ways in his life. That's why he signed himself as Captain Bonsdale. Clear? So, understanding the text. Next question is, how does a peddler interpret? We are not having much time, beta. Clear? But you will be reading these questions and solving it also. And you need to take notes of value points, you know, in during the vacations also. You have to note down all the value points at one place.